Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be an updated Star Wars review on Star Wars The Clone Wars Adventure Gear Padme Amidala. This Padme Amidala figure is obviously from The Clone Wars, and this is her adventure gear. I just decided to update this review because I did a review like a long time ago and it just needs updating. And I will be going back and getting, you know, picking out a few other Star Wars figures that I feel that do need updating as well, just because new review material right now isn't coming in. So if you see anything in my collection you want reviewed, just let me know. So Padme wore this outfit throughout the Clone Wars, and this is one of two of the Clone Wars Padme Amidala figure. Before we take a look at the figure itself, we'll take a look at the packaging. Of course, I do have the figure carded, but we have at the top there, it says 4+, Star Wars The Clone Wars logo, image of Padme. There is the figure, Star Wars The Clone Wars, grappling hook launcher, Padme. She is number 35. On the back is the figure right there. A picture of Padme. A read-up. If you guys would like to pause and read, you guys can. Or Padme comes hostage aboard the Malevolent since the deadly separatist ship commanded by General Grievous, the courageous senator escapes her captors and contacts nearby Republic forces. She and C-3PO avoid battle droids, Redovis, I'm not sure what it says, with her rescues Anakin and Obi-Wan Kenobi. And of course, the other figures you can get in this line. And there's another Star Wars logo, the Clone Wars logo. And of course, nothing on the bottom, just Hasbro and stuff like that. So there's the figure. Let's take a look at Padme herself. Not the figure, the card. So Padme's articulation is a ball-jointed head, ball and shoulders, hinge elbows, swivel in the wrist, swivel in the hips, swivel in the waist, ball hinge knees, and that is all the articulation. So, not bad articulation. You know, you get enough, you can pose her and stuff. This Padme figure is very simple. She does still have nice detail on her, as you can see. Paint is nice and stuff, but it's pretty much all one color. She has the leather right there. And oh, she does have a swivel on her wrist too, I guess. Forgot that. Her chest is very nice. Her vest, you can see right there, she has a little badge. The hair is really nicely done. I like how that hairstyle is. It almost looks like dreadlocks. She has little clips in her hair. The boots are all one color. And the face. I think the face does resemble Padme, but to me, it's not dead on, obviously. It's still a nice one, but it's not dead on. You can see her belt right there with a little pouch. There's her holster, and so on. So her accessories, now she doesn't come with a base, but I just give her one. And she actually comes, as you can see, with this launcher. Now, I got my loose figure in a trade a long time ago, so I don't have the rocket launcher, which is fine. I wouldn't use it anyway. The only accessory I have for her is the pistol. But as you can see, this is not the same pistol as the one in the packaging. The one in the packaging is much bigger. But this one does just fine. You can either put it in her hand. Like so, or you can take it out and put it in her holster. Like so. It has a nice snug fit in there, so, you know, it won't fall out or anything. I'm actually going to bring the original Clone Wars Padme in, for comparison, and I was going to review this one today, but I decided to do the Adventure Gear one. But as you can see, I'm going to focus on the face sculpts because the outfit is totally different. The face sculpt, I think, looks better on this one. It looks more like Padme from the show. I think the hair on the Adventure Gear one is a little too dark. I think the hair on this one is just right. But yep, there they are. Let me get Senator Amidala on on her stand. I display all of my Clone Wars figures on a stand, so.
She is having a little hard time seeing.
If you are a Padme fan, definitely recommend her. She would be a good addition to your Clone Wars collection, or if you're just like me and want every Padme figure, definitely get her. I like her. I would add both. I was going to say add this one, but put both in your collection. It's good to have both. This one is a more iconic look, and it's more show accurate, but add both to your collection. So that's going to be it for today. Today's review was on the Clone Wars Adventure Gear Padme Amidala. Let me know what other reviews you would like updated, and until next time, please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye. Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address. If you would like to send fan mail, feel free to do so. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye.